So children, this is our MS Word window. It's all component, it's all part, just now we had discussed. And now our next topic is creating a new document. So it's very simple. Okay, to create a new document we have to click on file tab. I have office button. Okay, so this is new option. Okay, when you click on file tab, no, so this menu appears. Okay, so first option you can see in this menu, there is new option. Click on this. Okay, so this is new document dialog box. Okay, you can see here, you can see blank and recent. This is blank document, it is already selected, so you need not to do anything here. You have to go to this create button. Okay, create button, I hope you can see this create button. Click on create button. Okay, so now this is new window. Okay, now new window has appeared, blank document area. Okay, and on title bar you can see what is written, document 2. Okay, means this is new document named document 2. Okay, previously I had opened golden egg, that was my document name. Now it's a new document. Okay, new document window. Okay, so to create a new document, 4 steps you have to follow. Go to the file tab, drop down menu appears, file menu appears, you have to click on new option, first option new. Okay, then blank document, it shows you blank document, and at the fourth step you have to click on create button. Okay, after clicking create button, this window will appear. Okay, this new document window appears. Clear? And there is a keyboard shortcut written in your book. Here, Control plus N key to create a new document. Smart tip. Okay, so which key you have to press? Control plus N. See, so this is now document 3. This is document 3. Okay, again a new document window appeared. Clear? No? Create, control plus N key, it's a shortcut key to create a new document. Clear? Now what is written next topic, it is adding text in the document. Okay, when you start typing, okay, text on computer, no, so cursor goes to the right side. Okay, cursor goes to the right side. Okay, so when you do typing, so you can see cursor, it's going to the right side, it keeps going right side. Okay, and automatically has come to the next line. Understood? You can see I'm not doing anything, but automatically cursor coming to the next line. I'm not pressing enter key to go to the next line, isn't it? In your previous class I taught you to go to next line we press enter key, but in MS Word when you are typing, okay, so when cursor goes to the end of the line, okay, so it comes to the next line automatically. It comes to the next line automatically. Okay, that time we don't press enter key to take to the next, to go to the next line. Okay, automatically it comes to the next new line. So this feature of MS Word is called word wrap feature. Understood? When cursor shift automatically to the next line, when it reaches the end of the line, this feature is known as word wrap. Again, you see, I'm typing, okay, and you see cursor, it's coming automatically to the next line. Okay, when I'm pressing enter key, now it has gone to the next line. But when it comes automatically to the next line, this feature is known as word wrap. Okay, now you see. So our topic is adding text. It is already written. I wrote story of golden eggs. It is given in your book, page number 39. Okay, for example, it is shown. Okay, so I also typed on my computer. Okay, this is story. Once upon a time, a farmer bought a special goose who laid a golden egg every day. Okay, this is this story. Okay, now our next topic is inserting new text. Okay, inserting new text. So I typed here, once upon a time a farmer. Now you can see in your book what is written there. Once upon a time, a farmer and his wife lived in a village. Then full stop. The farmer bought a special goose who laid a golden egg every day. So some text are missing here. Okay, so what I have to do, I have to add those text. Okay, means after farmer, you can see I placed my cursor after farmer, because after farmer I have to type here and his wife lived in a village. Okay, so wherever you have to insert text, no, new text, wherever you have to insert, first of all your cursor should be placed there. Understood? So I brought my cursor was here at the beginning of the line. Okay, wherever you will click, okay, cursor will be placed there. Okay, so cursor has come. Now I'm going to add and his wife, lived in a village, village, village. Okay, then full stop. After this, the farmer, F-A-R-M-E-R, farmer, okay, bought a special goose who laid a golden egg every day. So this way we can insert text. Okay, new text can be inserted in an existing document. Means this story I already had written there. Okay, but and his wife lived in a village, this is new text which I just now inserted. Okay, so wherever you have to insert your new text, place cursor there. Okay, your cursor should be placed there, then start typing. Okay, understood? Now selecting text. Next topic is selecting text. Okay, so selection of text, it is very simple. Okay, what you have to do to select text, first of all, whichever text you want to select, place your cursor there. Suppose I want to select this heading, so click there. Okay, cursor has come. Now press left key and drag. Okay, drag your mouse. Dragging mouse also you can press, you can select text. And one more thing can be done, place cursor, hold shift key and keep pressing right arrow key. Okay, you will see one by one all letters will be selected. Understood? Once again, see, place cursor, hold shift key, press right arrow key, letter by letter, whole text will be selected. You have to keep press right arrow key. Understood? So this is the way to select text. Now you want to deselect. Okay, how deselecting will be? Press escape key or click anywhere. Press escape key or click anywhere in the document. So selected text will be deselected. Clear? I hope it's clear to you. Now next very interesting topic, it is beautifying text. Okay, now to beautify text we have to select it, because without selection beautification cannot be done. Drag mouse over the text. Okay, text will be selected. Now go to the font style button. Okay, here you see font size, font style, Calibri is written. No, click on this arrow, it will show you different styles of writing: Constantia, Arial, Constantia, Alzarian. Okay, so whichever style you want, you can take from here. There is a long list of, I selected Algerian. Okay, so this is Algerian style. Then size, I selected here 22. So number, whichever large number you will select, no, text will be accordingly will be resized. Okay, then here is font color. This is font color button. Okay, click this, and whichever color you like, click that. Okay, font size, font color, font style. Okay, so whichever you want can be applied. Okay, understood? Now font size, this is font style button, this is font size button, this is font color button. Okay, bold, italic, underline, all these are buttons to beautify text. Okay, used for beautifying the text. Okay, now you can see underlined it. I underlined too. Clear? No. Heading is changed. Okay, it now came in golden, red color. Understood? Very simple. Now deleting text. Text can be deleted. Okay, text which you don't want can be deleted. It's very easy. Select the text which you don't want. Suppose this heading only. So first of all, select this text, place your cursor beginning of the text and drag mouse. Selected. And delete key. We have delete key on keyboard. Okay. Or backspace key. Both keys can remove text. Delete key. Heading is deleted. Hana? So this way we can delete text. Okay. And at the quick access toolbar, we have undo and redo button. If you want your heading again back to the document, undo button. So now you see, undo button, it has undone the last command and brought the heading back, which we had deleted in last command. No, now appeared again. Isn't it? Undo button. Okay. Now, save document. this document, it is already saved. Okay, I'll change document name. This is save button again. Quick access toolbar. See, save button. And control plus S key. Control plus S key is a shortcut key to save a document. Okay. And in file tab also, when you click on file tab, okay, so there is a save button, save option here. Save option is there. So click on this option, save, dialog box appears. See, okay. Okay, so here you have to type file name. What do you have to type here? File name. So whichever name you want to give, you can do. Okay, golden golden e double g egg 3. Okay, this time I gave my file name in short small letters, okay, lowercase letter. File name I typed here. Where you want to save file? You can see this. This is save as dialog box, okay. And here, file name box. File name you have to type. I typed here golden egg 3, okay. Now where you want to save your file? In this menu you have to see where you want to save. I want to save my file on desktop, so click on desktop. Okay, path you can see desktop. Okay, so now this file will be saved on desktop. And finally you have to click on save button. Simple. File is saved. You can see file name golden egg in small letters. Okay, this is file name golden egg 3. Okay, and where is it saved? It is saved on desktop. Clear? So this is the method to save file. Very simple. Few steps you have to follow. First of all, you have to click on file tab. File menu appears, then you have to click on save as option. Save as dialog box will appear. Okay, here you can see again file tab, save as option. Okay, then this is save as dialog box. Here you have to type your file name, file name box. Where do you want to save file? So here you have to select where you want. So book is also saving on desktop. Okay, so desktop option it is chosen. And finally at the last step you have to click on save button. Clear now children? With this your file will be saved, okay, on desktop. Clear? Clear now? Yes. Now if you want to open an existing document, okay, it happens we make several documents in computer. So existing document, how will you open? Go to the file tab. File tab, it will show you open option. Here you see open option. Click on open option. So this is open dialog box. Which one? Open dialog box. Now which file you want to open? Okay, so file which you want to open, you can choose from here. Okay, golden egg. Many are there. Suppose documents shortcut. You
click on open.
So from here now you can open your file. I'm not opening from here. Okay, so open dialog box helps you to open file. Clear? From your book too, you can understand from here too. This is your file tab. This is open option. This is open dialog box. Okay. You have to choose which file you want to open. First of all, choose location, your file location, and select the file which you want to open, and then finally click on open button. File will be open. Okay, and to close, last topic, to close MS Word window, which button do you have to click? Close button. Simple. Go to the close button. Okay. Close button. Click. Understood? This way we can close file. Clear? So this is the chapter, children. We have done today our third chapter. We have done MS Word window. Okay. I hope you understood all the topics. Okay. Do all homework which I gave you. Learn question answers. Don't waste your time at home. And do study, children. Okay. Bye.